Hi everyone, I'm Daniel Waisberg. I'm an analytics advocate at Google, and I'm here with Rick Elliott. He's a technical writer in the analytics education team, and he's responsible for the Help Center, Data Studio Help Center. So welcome, Rick. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
So, Rick, can we start, what exactly do you do at Google, and how does your day-to-day look like?
Yeah, so as Daniel said, I'm a technical writer, and at Google that encompasses a lot of different things, but primarily I'm in charge of producing help content for the Help Center, tutorial videos, tutorial reports, and working on the text that's actually in the product, all that is meant to communicate how to use the product effectively.
Okay, can you share with us how is the life of a Help Center article? I mean, how does it go from conception to production?
It's a good question. So first of all, every piece of content that we produce, we produce that with the customer, the user in mind. So I don't want to write anything that doesn't actually help people use the product. So there's always a question about what do we need to communicate? Depending on, a lot of times that's a new feature that gets released or a question from an actual user, or sometimes I just am using the product and have questions or realizations myself, so I get a bee in my bonnet to write some piece of content. Once the decision's been made to write some content or produce any kind of help material, the next step is to figure out, okay, what's the best way to do that? Does it belong in the Help Center? Is it best done with a tutorial or a sample report? And then it's just a process of interviewing the experts, the subject matter experts, using the product myself. I do a lot of playing around with the product. There's some back and forth with reviews. And at a certain point, we declare victory and publish it. And then if there's more feedback, then we'll revise it and move on. So it's a kind of an organic process.
Cool. So there is a new section, the chart reference, which is a new section on the Help Center, and it's a massive amount of information. It's really a great section. I really enjoy and helps me a lot working with Data Studio. Can you share a little bit about the process of writing that section particularly?
Yeah, so that was an example pretty much of me getting a bee in my bonnet. I have been thinking that we needed to have some basic information on the types of charts. Perhaps not all of our users are going to be data visualization experts. And it also came into existence because we actually have some complicated configuration options in some of those charts, but they're pretty minute details. And it would be a little strange to just have an article on a particular widget like data to zero, missing data, those kinds of small configuration options. So having those two ideas in my head, I thought that it would be good to have an article on each chart type that documented kind of theoretically what that particular kind of chart was good for. Like what is a bullet chart and why might I want to use it? How do we, what are our customizations in Data Studio? Like how is a bullet chart in Data Studio perhaps different from the normal bullet chart? And then some examples, and then finally all of the configuration options that are there. So as the complexity or features of the charts expand in the future, we have a place to put that information. And it turned into this 9-article tome.
Yeah. So one of the things that I really like about the Data Studio Help Center is that, it's very diverse, right? So there are videos, as you said, and, lots of images on how to do things. But by far, the most amazing help that we get from you is the tutorial that you wrote for Data Studio, which really, it's like you're holding people's hand and leading them into learning how to use Data Studio on a step-by-step. And so where did you get the idea from?
So that's what we call the warm welcome report. And the idea with that fundamentally was how could we use Data Studio to teach Data Studio? And this is something that we have kind of a unique opportunity to do with the Data Studio product because it's so visual, and we have this canvas that we can put text and images and interactive reports. And so a user can come in, a new customer can come in, see this report, we're able to annotate it, and lead people through the process of the most basic steps of getting started with Data Studio. This whole idea began as a conversation between the lead designer on the product, Dave Wright, and myself, and we were looking at some other products, both Google products, Google Keep, as well as some other tools that we use here, like Camtasia, that have tutorials built right into the product using the product. And we thought, well, how can we do that with Data Studio? And so we came up just basically with this simple multi-page report that we annotated. My favorite part of the report are the little post-it notes that we put on there to give people tips. And those are simply images that we put some text on, and I think it works pretty well.
It does. I really enjoyed it, going through the whole process. Thanks. So, I mean, as a technical writer, I guess you have to be really sharp when it comes to the product, right? You have to understand and use it. I mean, do you use it on a day-to-day basis?
It sure helps, yeah. I do, actually. I do a lot of, I probably create 5 or 6 reports every day as I'm writing articles, or I'll use the same report over and over again and apply charts and visualizations and controls and make sure I understand how they work. But I've also used the product internally to track some of the things that I'm interested in. How many people are coming to our help center, for example, in Google Analytics. I've put together a dashboard for that. And so by actually putting myself in the user's shoes, literally, I'm able to feel where the pain points are, understand what I needed to know to get started. And I'm not a data visualization expert, so sometimes I ask really basic questions, and it turns out that other people have those questions as well. So,
mm-hmm. Great. So, last question. There are many bloggers out there writing about data visualization, about Data Studio, about Google Analytics. Where do you find the muse to write the articles, and how do you get the ideas?
I read a lot of poetry. Technical writing is a different kind of writing, but you do have to have some inspiration for it. And for me, it really is the user, putting myself in my customer's shoes, asking myself, what do they need to know? What would I want to know? Understanding what's frustrating, because the product is in development and there are some sharp edges, and we want to fix those. And sometimes we have to document them, and then we fix them later on. So it's an evolving process, but always it comes down to trying to figure out how to take something that might be a bit complex and make it simple. And that's the fun part of it. That's kind of like a puzzle. I think every technical writer really enjoys that mental challenge. And publishing for the web is actually, it has a maker component to it as well. When I get to press that publish button and see it live and know that hundreds, if not thousands, of people are seeing stuff that I wrote. It's both, it's a little scary, but it's also super cool to see it just appear there in the world. So that gives me a bit of a charge every day.
Great. So thank you very much for the, for sharing the knowledge, and thank you very much for writing all this amazing stuff. I'm sure that it's helping many, many thousands of people, and it's really helpful. So thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you.